How much did you say?
Only 3 guineas, Mr. Sowerberry. A bargain if ever there was one.
And I was looking for a boy. All right, bring him in, Mr. Bumble. Bring him in.
Ah, my love. I've said we might consider taking this boy to help in the shop.
Dear me. He's very small.
Well, he is rather small, there's no denying, but he'll grow, Mrs. Sowerberry, he'll grow.
I dare say he will. And our victuals and our drink. These workhouse boys always cost more than they're worth. Where did he come from?
Mother came to us destitute. She brings a child into the world, takes one look at him, and promptly dies. Without leaving so much as a forwarding name and address. So here he is. Yours for 3 guineas as agreed. Cash on delivery.
Oh, no. No, Mr. Bumble, no, no. Cash upon liking. A week on approval. If we get enough work out of him without putting too much food into him, then we'll keep him.
But he's a can help no Claypole. Put the shutters up. Do you hear now? Then he can clean out the stables and fill the lamps and sweep the yard.
I'll look after him, Mrs.
You see, my dear, it occurred to me that he'd make a delightful coffin follower, that, that expression of melancholy. It's very interesting, don't you think so, my love? I don't mean a regular coffin follower to attend grown-up people. No. Just for children's funerals.
Mute in proportion, so to speak.
Precisely. Superb effect, don't you think so, my love?
Do you think you could look like that gentleman up there?
Perhaps. If I had a tall hat.
Mother work us.
You leave my mother out of it. She's dead.
What'd she die of? Shortage of breath?
You better not say anything about her to me.
But don't you be cheeky, work us. The old mother. She was a nice one.
A regular right down bad and she was.
What did you say?
And it's a good thing she died when she did, because she'd been in prison doing hard labor last time.
Oh,
no.
Oh, oh, oh.
What a murdery foul!
What's going on down here? What are you trying to do? Waking the dead or something? Oh, it's you,
you
get out of here!
Are
you spotting it?
Oh dear, I'm going off. Water. Water. Noah, run over to the workhouse. Get Mr. Bumble. Tell him to come quick.
Ah!
Do you know this here voice, Oliver?
Yes, I do.
Well, ain't you afraid of it, Oliver? Ain't you trembling when I speak, Oliver?
No, I'm not.
He's gone mad, Mr. Bumble, or he wouldn't dare to speak to you like that.
It's not madness, ma'am, it's meat.
Meat?
Meat, ma'am, meat. You overfed the boy, ma'am. You've raised an artificial spirit in the lad, unbecoming to his station in life. This would never have happened if you kept him on gruel.
Gruel?
I'll be glad to give you the recipe.
Well, well, well. Having a rest, Mr. Bumble?
He's sitting on Oliver.
Quite right. We must all sit on Oliver.
You've been drinking again.
I miss a friend in the cemetery.
Help!
Hmm. Who's in there? A coffin should not have been occupied until tomorrow. It's reserved for a very important client.
Stand back. Now then, what's your explanation, you young scallywag?
He called my mother names.
And what if he did, you ungrateful little wretch? She deserved what he said, and worse.
She didn't.
She did.
It's a lie.
Hold your tongue, boy.
Put him down in the cellar, Mr. Bumble. That'll teach him.
My love.
Yes.
It's really quite comfortable.
You'll stay down there till we decide what's to be done with you.
And here's your baggage, workhouse.
£3 indeed. You can take him back.